let's continue our session. Up till now, we have seen the definition and classification. Now, the problem is there. Solution is also here. Now, we will move forward. So, the aphorism number 178. Now, 177 we have completed. Now, the 178, what happened? It will no doubt sometimes happen that this medicine selected in strict observance of homeopathic law. So the medicine which you are selecting by your judgment, by your knowledge, on the basis of very few symptoms, so that medicine should be under the strict observance of homeopathic law. That means for the two symptoms, you should not prescribe two medicines. You have to give single dose. You have to follow minimum dose. That is, the massive dose should not be given to the patient, because that medicine will create artificial disease suited for the annihilation of the malady present. Any medicine, when you are giving any homeopathic medicine with a proper potency, with a proper dose, with the proper repetition, so ultimately it will produce the artificial disease. We know the modus operandi of the disease. So according to that, it will produce artificial disease. So the artificial disease should not be more violent, and hence the potency and the dose, that means the posology, are important for the annihilation of the malady. And this is much more likely to happen when these few morbid symptoms are very striking, decided, uncommon, and peculiarly distinctive. So if the symptoms which are few, and in that fewness, if the symptoms are striking, the symptoms are decided, the symptoms are uncommon. Decided means which will help to decide the medicine. Uncommon. So if these characteristic symptoms are present, then it is of no problem to that physician. So it is a very easy task to that physician to select the medicine, and that on the basis of the homeopathic law, because that medicine will produce artificial disease. So 178 aphorism is related to, if the symptoms are striking, decided, then there is no problem, no doubt in the selection of remedy. That remedy will produce artificial similar disease, but that medicine should be selected on the basis of homeopathic law. The next aphorism, 179. More frequently, however, the medicine that chosen in such a case will be only partial. That is to say, not exactly suitable, as there was no considerable number of symptoms to guide to an accurate selection. So what happened? Again, one problem arises here. More frequently, what happened? Medicine first chosen. Previously, we have seen we have to select the medicine, and which aphorism we have seen it in the aphorism number 177. In such case, we have to select the medicine on the basis of few symptoms, but with our judgment, the most indicated homeopathic remedy we have to select. So here again, in the continuation, he said that, or Dr. Hanuman said that, that medicine that you have chosen previously, that is only a partial similar. Because why it is partial similar? Because we know it is a OSD, that is a one-sided disease. That is to say, it is not exactly suitable. As there are reason bhi diya hai uska, as there was no considerable symptoms which will guide accurate selection. So the medicine that you will selected, that is the unhomeopathic or partial homeopathic medicine. Now the 180. In this case, the medicine which has been chosen as well as possible, but which for the reason above stated is the only imperfectly homeopathic. Humko pata hai, because of the few symptoms, it is imperfectly homeopathic. Then in its action upon the disease, that is only partially analogous. Analogous means similar. It is only a partially similar. Just as in the case mentioned in the 162 aphorism, we have completed the partial homeopathic remedy previously. So same thing will happen in the OSD also, where the limited number of homeopathic remedies renders, means make the selection imperfect. So symptoms are less, hence the selection will be imperfect. And this leads to formation of accessory symptoms. So what are the accessory symptoms? The symptoms which produces after the selection of impartial remedy or imperfect homeopathic remedy, and several phenomena from its own array of symptoms are mixed up with the patient's state of health, which are, however, at the same time symptoms of the disease itself, although they may have been hitherto never or very rarely perceived. Some symptoms which the patient had never previously experienced appear, or others he had only felt indistinctly became more pronounced. So here what they have given, the about accessory symptoms. So accessory symptoms are those symptoms, it may belongs in the symptoms which produce because of imperfectly homeopathic remedy. And this imperfect selection is because of, or the partial analogous selection of medicine is only because of few symptoms. And these few symptoms are not rare, they are not characteristics. So this leads to accessory symptoms. Now, these accessory symptoms may be of two types: accessory symptoms of medicine and accessory symptoms of disease. So what are the accessory symptoms of disease? Here it is given. The array of symptoms are mixed with the patient's state of health, which are, however, at the same time symptoms of the disease itself. So by giving the medicine, the other symptoms of that particular disease, for example, we have discussed the example of stomachache previously. So now, after giving this remedy or this medicine, we will say here not a remedy but a medicine. So because of the action of that medicine, partial action, the disease may not cure, but the disease may show the certain symptoms which are not shown previously. So after giving your doses, the patient may say that, okay, now I am also suffering from diarrhea. And this clears that patient may have the gastritis, or that patient may have some problem, that is a hyperacidity. So the symptoms of the disease may arises, the array of the symptoms may arises, which belongs to the disease, that is known as accessory symptoms of disease, जो पहले कभी भी नहीं परसीव हुए थे या फिर वेरी रेयरली परसीव हुए थे टू द पेशेंट. सम सिम्टम्स विच द पेशेंट हैड नेवर एक्सपीरियंस. सो ऐसा भी हो सकता है कि वो पहले कभी नहीं भी थे या फिर रेयरली परसीव हुए थे, इनडिस्टेंटली उनको फील हुए थे. सो दीज आर द एसेसरी सिम्टम्स. सेकेंड टाइप है द एसेसरी सिम्टम्स ऑफ मेडिसिन. यहाँ पे नहीं दिया है वो, but the accessory symptoms of medicine is, for that you should know the pathogenicity of that medicine. You should know how that medicine will act on the body. The if you know the action of that medicine, and if you know the pathology of the disease, then it is very easy ki that accessory symptoms medicine ke hai ya डिजीज के हैं. जैसे आपने पहले उनको दिया था नक्सफोबी का पेशेंट को, नाउ द सिम्टम्स अराइजेस. सो इफ दैट सिम्टम्स, अगर आपने उसको मान लिया कि दैट डायग्नोसिस इज द गैस्ट्राइटिस, फॉर द सेकेंड टाइम इफ यू रिपीटेड दैट मेडिसिन एंड अगेन द न्यू सिम्टम अराइजेस, दैट पेशेंट बिकेम मोर इरिटेबल, दैट पेशेंट थर्स्ट इज चेंजेस, that means that accessory symptoms may belong to medicine. So ये आपको वहाँ पे differentiate करना है. It is not a easy task, but जैसे जैसे patient को आप पे विश्वास होता जाएगा, as the medicine is get repeated, the potency changes or the doses increases, वैसे वैसे one-sided disease भी clear picture form करते जाएगा. So in that one-sided disease, the accessory symptoms may arises, which belongs to the disease or may belongs to the medicine, where the symptoms are because of the prescription of partial similar homeopathic medicine, and these symptoms may not felt by the patient, or if felt, they are rarely perceived by the patient. So this is nothing but the accessory symptom. On this, the 2-mark question come to define the accessory symptoms, or may sometime 5-mark question comes. So in that, you have to write down about the number of aphorism, in which condition you will get accessory symptom, types of accessory symptoms, and what to do in that accessory symptoms. All these points should be covered in the 5-mark question. Now we will move further. Aphorism 181. Let it not be objected that the accessory phenomena and new symptoms of this disease that now appear should be laid to the account of the medicament just employed. By owe their origin to it, certainly, but they are always only symptoms of such a nature as this disease was itself capable of producing in these organisms, and which are summoned forth and induced to make their appearance by the medicine given, owing to its power to cause similar symptoms. In a word, we have to regard the whole collection of symptoms now perceptible as belonging to the disease itself, as the actual existing condition, and to the direct or our further treatment accordingly. So what he said here, he लेट इट नॉट बी ऑब्जेक्टेड. आपने वो पेशेंट को ध्यान देना है व्हेन द एसेसरी फिनोमिना, यहाँ पे एसेसरी सिम्टम्स आते हैं या न्यू सिम्टम्स ऑफ द डिसीज आते हैं. नाउ दे शुड बी लेट अकाउंट, सो दे शुड बी टेकन इनटू द अकाउंट फॉर द मेडिकामेंट यू हैव जस्ट एम्प्लॉयड. तो आपने जो मेडिसिन उसको दी थी, दो इट इज अ पार्शियली सिमिलर, उसके वजह से उसको न्यू सिम्टम्स आए हैं, उसके वजह से उसको एसेसरी सिम्टम्स आए हैं, सो दैट सिम्टम्स शुड बी एडेड टू फॉर द प्रिस्क्रिप्शन. देयर ओरिजिन, दे ओ देयर ओरिजिन टू इट, दे आर वेरी नेसेसरी टू इट, बट दे आर ऑलवेज ओनली सिम्टम्स ऑफ सच अ नेचर एज दिस डिजीज वॉज इटसेल्फ capable of producing in this organism. ये उस पे ही क्यों आए हैं? Because these symptoms are the belongs to the disease, और उसको disease है of chronic nature. तो वो कभी ना कभी तो आने वाले हैं. It will summon forth, यानी वो आगे चल के आने वाले हैं. They will induce the appearance by medicine even. वो अभी क्यों आए? Because of your unhomeopathic remedy. और वो अनहोम्योपैथिक मेडिसिन को पावर क्या है? टू कॉज सिमिलर सिम्टम. उसने आर्टिफिशियल डिजीज वहां पे प्रोड्यूस किया एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दैट पेशेंट इज हैविंग एसेसरी सिम्टम, दैट पेशेंट इज हैविंग अ न्यू सिम्टम दैट यू शुड टेक इनटू अकाउंट. दैट इज द यूजफुलनेस ऑफ दैट आर्टिफिशियल दैट पार्शल सिलेक्टेड मेडिसिन. सो अगर सिम्टम्स आते हैं उसको, सो दिस ओ अटेंशन, दिस इज द इम्पॉर्टेंट. इन अ वर्ड वी हैव रिगार्ड द होल कलेक्शन ऑफ सिम्टम्स, यानी उसके प्रीवियस सिम्टम एंड नाउ द एसेसरी सिम्टम्स, ये आपको वहां पे एड करने हैं. एंड दे बिलोंगिंग टू द डिसीज इटसेल्फ, क्योंकि वो डिसीज के ही है, बिकॉज वो पहले कंडीशन में थे लेकिन पेशेंट ने नहीं बताया या उसको परसीव नहीं हुआ, वॉट एवर मे बी द रीजन, बट दे शुड बी टेक इनटू द अकाउंट फॉर द ट्रीटमेंट. नेक्स्ट 182, दस द इम्परफेक्ट सिलेक्शन ऑफ मेडिकामेंट विच वॉज इन दिस केस ऑलमोस्ट इनविटेबल owing to the too limited number of the symptoms present, serves to complete the display of symptoms of the disease and in this way facilitates the discovery of second, more accurately suitable homeopathic medicine. So, aapne jo first medicine usko di thi, that we have seen in the aphorism number 177, to wo imperfect selection jo medicament thi, which is the inevitable owing, यानी उसके वजह से क्या हुआ? The limited number of symptoms, accessory symptoms उसको आए, and which helps us to complete the display of symptoms, and this leads to the discovery of second most accurate homeopathic medicine. So अभी जो आपको symptoms मिले थे, यानी पहले के symptoms plus accessory symptoms, ये दोनों मिला के आपको एक मेडिसिन देनी है विच इज मोर सुटेबल, विच इज मोर होम्योपैथिक. सो नाउ जैसे मैंने पहले ही कहा था कि पेशेंट 2 to 3 सिटिंग्स में पेशेंट को सिम्टम्स आएंगे, द पेशेंट विल ओपन टू यू एंड नाउ द केस विल बी अ मोर इंटरेस्टिंग. वी विल मूव फर्दर. In aphorism number 183, whenever therefore the dose of the first medicine ceases to have a beneficial effect, if the new developed symptoms do not, by reason of gravity, demand more speedy aid, which however, from the minuteness of the dose of the homeopathic medicine and in very chronic diseases is exclusively rare. A new examination of the disease must be instituted. the status morbi as it now is must be noted down and a second homeopathic remedy selected in accordance with it, which will exactly suit the present state, and one which shall be all the more appropriate can then be formed as the group of symptoms has become larger and more complete. So this is a very informative aphorism. This is very indicative aphorism, that is 183. So kya kaha hai unhone? Whenever, therefore. That therefore, now this is the conclusion, a short conclusion, the dose of first medicine, that is the unhomeopathic medicine, ceases, stops to have a beneficial effect. Kab? Jab a new examination of disease must be instituted. So, jo medicine aapne di hai, वो मेडिसिन अगर आपने कम डोज में दी है, रिपीटेशन अगर ज्यादा नहीं है, तो वो एसेसरी सिम्टम्स प्रोड्यूस करेगी. न्यू सिम्टम्स वहां पे अगर आता है तो उसकी ग्रेविटी कम रहती है, इट इज नॉट टू मच वायलेंट, एंड दिस विल डिमांड और दिस विल लीड्स टू द स्पीडी रिकवरी ओनली बिकॉज ऑफ द माइन्यूटनेस ऑफ द डोज ऑफ द होम्योपैथिक मेडिसिन. And which has to be exclusively rare in the very chronic diseases, because we are giving the medicine repeatedly in very chronic diseases. So this has to be kept into the mind. If it is OSD and it is a chronic case, so we have, and you are not in a position to select the medicine, the first medicine should be given in a smaller doses. So that when you want to give a second medicine on the basis of old and the accessory symptoms, the beneficial effect of the first medicine will help to increase the symptoms, and at the same time, because of the minuteness of the dose, it will not create the violent symptoms. A new examination of disease yahan pe hum karenge, and you will get the status morbi, यानी status morbi यानी disease की condition. तो आपको यहाँ पे disease की condition अच्छे तरह से पता चल जाएगी. Then what you can do? You can select second homeopathic remedy. किसके हिसाब से? According to the present state, original diseases plus accessory symptoms. That will be your present state. One which shall be a more appropriate. So that will be a more appropriate, and that can be found as the group of symptoms now increase and now became a complete. So this is very, very, very informative aphorism, that is 183, which clears the picture very easily. Ki kya karna hai, kya karne se kya hoga, if you are properly following homeopathy law, that is the minuteness of dose. In aphorism number 184, in like manner, after each new dose of medicine has exhausted its action, when it is no longer suitable and helpful, the state of the disease that is still remains is to be noted anew with respect to its remaining symptoms, and another homeopathic remedy sought for as suitable as possible for the group of symptoms now observed, and so on until the recovery is complete. So again, this is a concluding aphorism. What he said, if the each new dose of medicine has exhausted its action. आपने दूसरी medicine उसको select की, उसकी action भी exhaust हो गई. When it is no longer suitable and helpful, लेकिन दूसरी medicine भी आपको selection में problem आ गया, which is not suitable. The state of disease still remains as it is. The new symptoms are remaining then again you have to find out the third another homeopathic remedy which is to be a most suitable. और ये हमको कब तक करते रहना है, जब तक वो रिकवरी कंप्लीट नहीं होती है. सो दिस इज द केस ऑफ ओएसडी कि जहाँ पे ये प्रॉब्लम्स आते हैं अगेन एंड अगेन यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द मेडिसिन जब तक रिकवरी इज द रिकवरी विल नॉट बी कंप्लीटेड. सो पेशेंट को जब तक ठीक नहीं लगता है तब तक यू हैव टू फाइंड आउट द मेडिसिन. So we will take a short recap of all the aphorisms. 172, few symptoms. 173, definition. 174, classification, internal and external. 175, portrait of disease will not be possible. 176, you have to do the proper clinical examination with proper case taking. 177, few guiding symptoms are present and hence we have to use our judgment and we have to select the medicine. 178, if the symptoms are uncommon and characteristics, then it is very good and the medicine should be selected on the strict observance of homeopathic law. 179, if the first chosen remedy is partially selected, then this is not a accurate selection. Then what will happen? This will produce accessory symptoms. So accessory symptoms of disease will produce which are never felt by patient previously. And which if it is perceived, it is very rarely. So in that case, what we have to do? And this is because of unhomeopathic or the imperfectly homeopathic medicine. In the next aphorism, he has given that because of that imperfect medicine, now you will get the certain new symptoms. Add that new symptom in the actual existing condition. And then give the further treatment. 182. This shows that the second remedy aapko choose karni hai on the basis of this presenting symptoms and the old symptoms. 183, very much important. If you are giving the minute dose, then that first medicine will not causes any harm to the patient. अभी आपको बिकॉज ऑफ द हिस्ट्री टेकिंग यू विल गेट द स्टेटस मॉर्बी एंड यू हैव टू सिलेक्ट सेकेंड होम्योपैथिक रेमेडी एंड दिस सेकेंड होम्योपैथिक रेमेडी विल हेल्प टू रिमूव द ग्रुप्स ऑफ सिम्टम्स. लेकिन 184 में उन्होंने दिया है कि इफ इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर दैट सेकेंड मेडिसिन ऑल्सो टू रिमूव द डिजीज कंडीशन, then you have to select the medicine tab tak jab tak aap wo patient recover nahi hota hai tab tak. So this is all about the one sided diseases. From the aphorism number 185 to 195, we will learn the local maladies. What are the local maladies? So local maladies means the classification mein unhone diya hai which is of external kind. See here, the principal symptoms may be internal or it may be the external kind. So usme aata hai local diseases. So this local diseases and whenever the local diseases are there, it is again of two kind. Ki jahan pe aapko internal mechanical help necessary hai and there is no need to give the surgery, but sometime this local maladies really need the dynamic aid or really need the medicinal help. So what we have to do there, dynamic medicine if you are giving, so that will be a beneficial to the patient. But At the same time, if you are applying the ointments, if you are applying the lotions, so that will create the problem. This will leads to the palliation. The mycelium will increase inside your body. That will be in a passive state, or that is in a latent state. And after the period of time, as the immunity decreases, it will come forward. That we called it as suppression. So this, all the things are given in the local maladies. So if the local maladies, where only mechanical help is sufficient, for example, dislocation, laceration, or the stitching where the injury is there, so it is okay. But if the patient is having fever, if the patient is not recovering in 2 to 3 days, then there we have to give the dynamic aid, that is medicine. But at the same time, you should not apply the externally. Otherwise, you will not have any idea ki externally wo theek ho jayega aur aapko lagega the patient is cured, but that mycelium will increase inside. Wo sora mycelium dheere dheere increase hote jayega. And this may lead to the psychotic condition. Isiliye, after that, we will see the disadvantages of using external applications in the local maladies. So we will take a short introduction of this aphorism 185. So, as we have seen, 172 to 184, one-sided diseases. Here, the aphorisms are related to local symptoms and surgery. So, these are the local maladies, which again belong to one-sided disease, which is given in the aphorism number 185. 186, they have given the certain examples of external local malady. In the 187, they have given that sometimes similar medicine may require. 188, Dr. Hanuman said that the limited parts are affected. When merely a topical application or the mechanical aid is sufficient. 189, but if the external malady, agar bahut zyada injury hai, severe hai, so we have to give dynamic aid. If you are giving the dynamic aid ya fir aap bahar se application laga rahe ho, so the annihilation and the cure of the general medicine of the malady should be by means of internal remedies. If aapne external aapko treat agar aap lotion laga rahe ho, so that will not be a complete cure. So in this way, so many aphorisms are there. We will consider it under the heading local maladies. Of course, it belongs to the class chronic disease. Okay, so read this aphorism, and if you have any query, you can ask me anytime. अरे ये क्या आ गया यहाँ पे. सो वी हैव सीन 172 184, एंड इफ यू हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम इन दिस एफोरिज्म दैट इज 160 to 171, आई थिंक यू हैव गिवन द ट्यूटोरियल आल्सो ऑन दिस कि द एग्रीवेशन ऑफ क्रॉनिक डिसीजेस. अगर होम्योपैथिक मेडिसिन यहाँ पे हम लोग देते हैं तो व्हाट विल हैपन. इफ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी इन दिस यू कैन आस्क मी एट एनी टाइम. ओके, सो दिस कंप्लीट्स आवर हाफ पोर्शन ऑफ वन साइडेड डिसीजेस. सो इफ यू वांट, बिकॉज यू आर नॉट हैविंग बुक्स, That's why I'm showing it online. You can take a screenshot and you can make the notes of it so that it will be easier to you to study. Okay.